Rangers' third consecutive defeat. They will start the game with Kevin Rooney, Colin Blackwell, and Phil DiGiuseppe. For the Caps, their very effective line, Carl Hagelin, Nick Dowd, and Garnet Hathaway. They combined for 2 goals, 3 assists.
There we go.
Right off the faceoff. Yeah. 3 fights simultaneously. Rooney and Dowd. DiGiuseppe going at it with Hathaway, Blackwell, and Hagelin. 1 second in.
First of all, classy move by Blackwell. He had Hagelin down and he didn't throw an extra punch. Hathaway and DiGiuseppe are really getting after one another. That reminds me of when John Tortorella coached the Rangers and Pete DeBoer coached the New Jersey Devils, and they got after it, Kenny. You were here to do that game. I was here to do that game with Doc Emmerich, and it got a whole lot of nasty. That was a lot of nasty right there. Remember, David Quinn, he's the home coach. He gets to put his roster in first, and you see Rooney's talking, Dowd's talking, and there's no messing around. Let's go. And I think everybody else got the message pretty early on there, Kenny. This was probably the highlight of all the bouts, with fists of fury flying both ways. See, Dowd out of Huntsville, Alabama, fighting Rooney out of Canton, Massachusetts, and those are two big, strong guys getting after one another.
All 6 players sent to the penalty box.
Ryan Poehling in that fourth line get the start, AJ, here at home.
Yeah, you know, they've been really good energy, setting the tone.
Early fight. Talk about setting the tone. It's Maroon and Delorier. These are two experienced heavyweights. Delorier, a little defense early. Watch out. Now he takes the upper hand. He takes Maroon down. And 2 seconds in, AJ, the tone's been set.
Well, that will get the temperature starting up high. Two big guys, as you said, and no surprise. If you were going to say there was a fight tonight, I would have picked those two guys. Maybe not 2 seconds into the game. But here we go.
Pat Maroon, the 35-year-old. He's done this a lot. Nick Delorier, 32. Over 30 fighting.
Yeah, you just look at right off the bat. They both knew it. Gloves off immediately. Pat Maroon looks like he's talking to him. You look at what they're trying to do here, right? They're coming in, trying to set the tone. You mentioned it. So now they got this. Both guys have some energy. The crowd's feeling it.
Let's try it again.
And so for the Ducks, shoot from everywhere, crash the net. You got to figure there's going to be pucks laying around the front of that San Jose Shark goal crease.
We'll keep an eye on that, and we're going to get a face-off or a fight right off the opening face-off brought to you by Coastline Auto. VL and Delorier dropped the mitts 3 seconds in. I beg your pardon, it's Sam Carrick. Carrick and VL went last year up in San Jose, and Carrick with some uppercuts, then some overhand rights, and VL answers with a few of his own. To his knees goes Carrick. He gets back up and delivers one more before VL knocks him down. And we've had quite a start already at Honda Center.
Yeah,
just 3 seconds in.
Predictable, wasn't it? The Sharks get blown out 8-0 last night at home against Nashville. You know that they were looking for energy right off the bat. Vial inserted into the lineup, and you can tell how he's getting ready. They've had the conversation. They know as soon as they drop the puck. By the way, players have got to wait until the puck is dropped before they can drop their stick and drop their helmet.
And we'll see how this thing unfolds. Good news for Nick Cousins. He's back skating and hopefully back in the lineup soon.
One thing the Panthers, they don't forget when one of their players gets taken advantage of. There we go.
And here we go off the draw. Lomberg against McBain. Gajewicz was looking to see if he would go with O'Brien. Ryan Lomberg doesn't take many faceoffs. And really didn't take that one.
Oh, there's some haymakers being thrown right there.
Now keep in mind, that's not Zucker. So when Lomberg went over to Zucker, they were chatting in the pregame. Others came over. So there's the first fight of the night, and we'll see if it's the only one at the 5-second mark.
Number 22, number 94, Arizona, Florida. Both guys for 5 each fighting.
Yeah, you don't see putting the mustard on it.
You don't see it very often, but this is a little carryover from the first meeting, as we just showed you. And the Panthers, they're a team that sticks together. And there you see, as soon as they drop the puck.
All right, so now Kevin Stenlund comes on to take the actual faceoff, perhaps.
Madison Square Garden has seen its fair share of bouts on the canvas, on the ice. No undercard tonight. Rempe and McDermott, the main event to open the hockey game.
Both sides. Lazar went the other side as well.
Jimmy Vesey and Lazar. Gaudreau has dropped them with Kevin Ball as well. Now it's 5-on-5. McDermott and Rempe exchanging blows. But everybody has gloves off at the Garden. DeAndre Miller and John Marino. There's only 4 officials. There's 5 fights. They're trying to break up what they can. Meanwhile, Rempe and McDermott still throwing them. DeAndre Miller got the better of John Marino down on the other end, as McDermott still feeding rights to Rempe. The other 4 are all done. The main event's still going.
This is unbelievable. Holy jump, and what a start to this one right here. But McDermott's got it. He had a couple of uppercuts.
This is a marathon between Rempe and McDermott.
Rempe's visor down. Oh, they got to be out of gas. Completely out of gas. Completely out of gas. Holy jumping. What a start to this one.
And Rempe coming over towards the Devil's bench as he fires up his own before he'll head to the penalty box, where he'll have plenty of company.
Did not say anything to their bench, though. He's out of gas. I mean, totally out. Just took a swing by, looked at his bench. And now Laviolette right here with Travis Green right behind me.
So 5 fights, the coach is getting into it, and we've had 2 seconds run off the clock. Peter Laviolette's coming back. Well, some tension was brewing heading into this hockey game. Everybody knew there was one fight about to happen. We got 5 and a little bit extra from the coaches. Well, it took him 2 seconds to blow the whistle, so not the fastest fight at Madison Square Garden, and everybody's headed off. Here's the interesting thing, Panger. I think they're saying that Lazar and Vesey got the gloves off first, which would make the other 4 fights a secondary altercation, which all have game misconducts attached to them. That's what the rule is if it's a secondary altercation, and they may be throwing 8 players out of the game off the opening faceoff.
They did drop them first. All eyes were on 73 and 23. And on the other side of the faceoff dot, that is correct, though. They were the first ones.
So again, the rules are if there's a fight ongoing and then another fight, it's considered a secondary altercation.
Yep.
That continues with game misconduct accompanies that.
They went first.
And if they say that Lazar and Vesey were the first fight, they're the only 2 left in the penalty box. Everybody else has been sent to the dressing room. Well, that certainly changes things. Just in terms of having 4 players on each bench ejected from the hockey game.
Fine line on that one. And the intensity of these 2 coaches, too. There it is right there. They went first, but we're all looking on my near side, which was Rempe, the main bout. And then McDermott. And then Marino goes Miller. And Miller, boy, he's a strong one, boy. He got the best of Marino on the right side. But everybody's looking at this one right here. And obviously, my conversation today with great fighters like Kelly Chase and Joey Koser that played for the New York Rangers won a cup here. Just talking about, you know, not sleeping all